Tim Burton's Batman from 1989 is just classic and probably my favorite of the Batman movies. It's not too dark and it's not too campy, so it's the perfect mix. Am I saying it's better than the Dark Knight movies? Probably not, but I mean, just in my opinion, I feel it's the best just because I like the older stuff, and also I just think this movie has the best performances. Now, don't get me wrong, I love The Dark Knight. Dark Knight is effing awesome, but I don't know, this one just always stuck out to me as my favorite. I like the style, I like the performances, I like just everything about it. This is a classy Batman movie. Now, sure, it doesn't follow the comics as perfect, seeing as Tim Burton didn't really read the comics, but I mean, I still think he did a really good job. And the music, don't get me started. This music is effing awesome. So let's just get into the movie. Let's talk about the performances first. First, let's talk about Michael Keaton as Bruce Wayne and Batman, because he went through the same thing that Ben Affleck is going through now. People did not want him playing Batman. In fact, they even petitioned, and it was all because of the movie he did called Mr. Mom, which, by the way, it wasn't that bad, but I could see how that comedy, people would say, like, oh, Mr. Mom's Batman, sort of how people are just like, oh, friggin' Daredevil as Batman, or friggin', Brokeback Joker when Heath Ledger was doing it. So we've all gone through that stuff before, and of course I ranted about Ben Affleck as Batman, but I'm over it now. In fact, I'm sort of rooting for him nowadays. But he did such a great job in this movie. He's so unassuming, and he actually makes me laugh, especially when Vicky Vale is asking which one of them is Bruce Wayne. He's like, oh, I don't know, even though he is a Bruce Wayne. And also, come on. Look at that smile that he does in the Batman suit. No other Batman could ever do that. That is badass. That is a Michael Keaton thing that only he can pull off. So I really liked him. And by the way, his Batman voice sounds natural. It sounds like an actual voice that some badass guy would have. It doesn't, like, Christian Bale's Batman voice clearly sounds like a fake voice. Here, let me give you a little back-to-back.
What are you?
I'm Batman.
What the hell are you?
I'm Batman. Nice coat.
Don't kill me! Don't kill me, man!
I'm not going to kill you. I want you to do me a favor. I want you to tell all your friends about me.
Where were the other drugs going?
I never knew. I don't know. I swear to God.
Swear to me!
I don't really have anything against Christian Bale's Batman voice. I'm just saying. The other one sounds a little bit more badass. But the person who steals the show in this movie, just absolute show stealer, and that's why his name is top credit, Jack Nicholson as the Joker. Oh my God. Everybody knows Jack in this movie. That's what this movie is pretty much known for. It's known for all the awesome Jack Nicholson Joker moments, and I just can't get enough of him. He probably does one of the best jobs ever. I haven't seen The Dark Knight in a while, so I can't really compare Heath Ledger and Jack Nicholson, and they really shouldn't be compared because they're two completely different Jokers, and these are two completely different movies. And I don't even think Jack Nicholson is the best Joker of all time. I think the best Joker of all time is Mark Hamill from the animated series, but that's besides the point. Just, you laugh along with Jack, and that's just like one of the best things ever, where you can laugh along with the villain. I don't know why, but I like to laugh along with the villain, and I think this movie is why. Just because he's such an enjoyable character. I mean, I know he's doing horrible things, he's killing people, he's gassing the city, but he's just having such a fun time with it. I mean, for God's sakes, he's throwing a parade and playing Prince and writing his name on art, and he just says some of the funniest things in this movie. I mean, congratulations, sir. He is the Joker.
Jack, listen. Maybe we can cut a deal. Jack.
Jack is dead, my friend. You can call me Joker. And as you can see, I'm a lot happier.
See, I don't even have to talk about it. The performance speaks for itself. But that laugh, oh God, that laugh, it just sends chills down my spine every time I hear it.
You understand that the nerves were completely severed, Mr. Napier. You see what I have to work with here.
I actually think the reveal of the Joker right there is one of the best scenes in film history. And it isn't even a reveal. The other part, where he shoots Jack Palance, is the real reveal. But the whole mirror part, just well executed, one of the best scenes in film history. And now we move on to Vicky Vale, played by Kim Basinger? How do you say your name? Kim? I never really knew. Kim Basinger? Basinger?
Or how to say this. Kim Basinger?
Anyway, she did a good job, even though she talks half and screams. Seriously, she barely has any lines. It's almost all screaming. It's hilarious. Also, like The Dark Knight, the hero and villain bounce off each other perfectly, and in this Batman universe, they are directly connected. Joker killed Batman's parents before he became the Joker, and Batman accidentally dipped him into the vat of acid. So they both have a grudge with each other, and they both want to settle it one way or another. It's perfect. The only complaint I have about this movie, and probably the next movie, is that Batman kills a couple of people, but that's okay, seeing as Tim Burton didn't really read the comics, and this is really technically the first of the newer Batman movies, so I'll let it pass, just because the rest of the movie is just too damn enjoyable to complain about it. So I give it a 9 out of 10. I highly recommend it. Any Bat fan should check it out. Any comic book fan, any comic book movie fan, if you haven't seen this movie already, which you should, go out and watch it. It's a really good time. It's just really fun. So, that's it. I'll be back with you with a review of Batman Returns. FDV, sign off.